Well, I think you left out one name, and that's DocuSign. And
well,
it's a
I know.
That
I could have gone down the list.
I
stopped. I stopped. But well, your point's well taken.
No, but there's a reason I mentioned DocuSign, because I think DocuSign is an example of what I would call an emerging growth stock that's not going away. There's been this paradigm shift in 2020, and now the realization is there's incredible scalable value in DocuSign. So that's not going away, even though we could classify it as an emerging growth type of stock. So I think there are select stocks that will stay with us for the duration that you could still own. But look, I think, you know, what Jim and Steph are talking about is this broadening out in the market. If you study the S&P 500, Scott, 90% of the S&P stocks right now are above their 200-day moving average. We have not seen that kind of broadening out strength since 2014. The mood of the market in the last several days seems to be much calmer. Volatility continues to decline. And I think what we're seeing is a representation that it does not have to be binary. It does not have to be all growth or all value. That can be a blend to both.
Yes, false dichotomy. That's right. And that's what is bugging me, is that I think people say, you know what? It can't be growth and value at the same time. That's just not true. Sometimes you're in a Pangloss moment. You have all these new buyers. You've got these people. Let's call them Robin Hood, okay? They like things. They are going to be buyers of Boeing. Now, we all knew that Boeing was going to get approved, right? But no, they're like, wow, Boeing. I got to go buy Boeing. So they just kind of like, they do. Oh, don't like, come on, that's what they do.
But Jim.
What?
Jim.
Yes?
I think there's a big difference between cyclicals and value stocks. I really do. Cyclicals means you're going to benefit from the economy improving, reopening, getting better. And these companies have cut costs so dramatically, the operating leverage is enormous. That's not to say I don't want to own secular technology stocks, because we've talked about this endlessly. You and I email all the time about total addressable markets and wanting to have exposure. But cyclicals are a little bit different than value. Some of them are in value sectors, but cyclicals are the ones that you want to own if you think the economy is going to recover and profits are going to recover.
I'm not going to disagree.